die swallow of the victim. Liturgy of the material of our blessed Lord at all time. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. This is the day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah, Christ is praising. Hallelujah, Christ is praising. Hallelujah, Christ is praising. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires are open, and for whom no secrets are hidden, bless the Lord of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and what we may magnify you through Christ. Glory be to God in the night, and peace be to God on earth. Lord God, everything, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, we take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You have seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayers. You alone are to be one. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, with the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, "We are all Israel. The Lord our God is one Lord. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. All your strength." This is the first commandment. And the second is like an immediate. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than this. And there is two commandments and one law and offense.
Lord God, I write that this relation.
God, so Lord, the Lord, that we call His Son Jesus Christ to save us from our sins. Be our advocate to them and we bring us to an eternal life. Hear us, Paul says, this thing is true and worthy of all acceptance. Christ Jesus came to the world to save sinners. Lord, let us confess our sins, repentance, and faith, firmly resolve to keep our commandments. We the Lord and peace with all people, let us live in the home of our God. As we say,
Almighty God,
Almighty God, our
Father,
our Heavenly Father, we have seen this in the face of the earth, in thought and word and deed, through readiness, through weakness, through our own effort. We have not sufficiently worked according to the mind of Christ. We have
named
the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son Jesus Christ, who died for us, give us all that is past, and grant us the blessed life in the midst of life, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, who forgives all who pray and beg, have mercy upon us.
Amen.
Pardon and deliver us from all our sins.
Amen.
Confirm and strengthen us in all things.
Amen.
And keep us in the light of God through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Collect, the Epistle, and the Gospel. First Sunday after Easter. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy did love the disciple with the signs of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence. The impression they present in the first chapter of the episode, or the first episode generally of Peter, began at 3:00. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Wherein we greatly rejoice, though now, for a season, it may be, ye are in evidence through manifold temptations, that the trial of faith be much more precious than gold that perishes, though it be tried with fire, but the power unto praise and honor and glory at the appearance of Jesus Christ, whom have not seen, ye love, in whom, though now ye see me not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls. This is the word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 24th chapter, the Gospel according to St. Luke, beginning at the first verse. Now, upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came from the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared, and certain others to them, and they found the stone rolled away.
Thank you. precious King of glory, we bless your name for this day. Thank you, Father, for the grace and the privilege to be in your presence as we go with our talent. We pray, Lord, to have brought this to you today. You will bless us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will continue to provide for us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. By your mercy and your pardon, you will feed us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray for glory by your mighty power. You will destroy the power of the devil upon our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will open the windows of heaven and rain blessings upon us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. The time you have brought to God, King of glory, we pray and accept it and sacrifice to God in the name of Jesus. Jesus, mighty name, we have prayed.
Praise His name. For there
Father in heaven, we thank you for the grace to God has set together, despite all the limitations to worship you. Accept our gratitude in the name of Jesus. We pray that your word will find a place in our hearts and in our mind, so much that we will establish your faith, despite the pains that the world is passing through Jesus Christ our Lord.
chapter 19, verses 32 and 33. Then came the soldiers and broke the legs of the first and of the other which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was dead already, they broke not his legs. John chapter 19, verse 32 and 33. In Luke chapter 23, verses 50 to 56. Luke 23, 50 to 56. We did not hear about angels. His 12 disciples, except his secret disciples. When we talk of secret disciples, means those people who are following Jesus afar, like so many people are doing today. They don't really come to church, but you see them monitoring what is going on in Christian faith, and they are following. It won't surprise us when in the last day we find even Muslims who were able to make it into the kingdom of God because they believe.
Stay away.
God. They were there until when there was an earthquake. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. That was not the end. That was not the end. The seal was broken and the stone rolled away. The speedy answer now came to the question being asked by the women in Mark chapter 16, verse 3. Women were asking, who will help us to roll this stone away? It became a problem to women when they came back. Maybe you are here this morning. That problem seems as who will do this one for me? Who is that prophet that will do it for me? As the entire world is facing the challenge of COVID-19, the entire world is looking for who is that person, that prophet, that man, or which country will proffer a solution to this problem that is shaking the entire world. It was a problem to the women, and the problem was rolled away. We pray COVID-19 will be rolled away from the entire world in the name of Jesus. It will be rolled away from Nigeria. It will be rolled away from Africa in the name of Jesus. The answer came when the women is expected. The answers of our prayers as believers concerning the entire world, concerning Africa, concerning Nigeria, the Lord will hear us in the mighty name of Jesus and put an end to this evil COVID-19 in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not die. We shall not. Maybe the speaker could have told us it wasn't the chief priests, the Pharisees, or Pilate himself. Maybe the speaker could have told us. Jesus could have done it. He could do it by the manifestation of the divine power. But it wasn't Jesus. Maybe the scriptures would have told us. Who wrote the stone? Who wrote the stone? The gospel according to Matthew gave the answer to this question. In Matthew chapter 28, verse 2. Matthew 28, verse 2. Let me read it from here. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. Today, angelic assistance will rise for your sake in the name of Jesus. You are never to find yourself weak. The Lord will make himself so strong in your life in the name of Jesus. Many times we wonder why, Lord, can't you help me? But have been told you have all the power. The silence of God does not mean God is weak in your life. You remember the time when Jesus Christ was in the boat and the storm was all around, beating the boat here and there. Jesus was still sleeping, he was still in the boat, and Jesus woke up and spoke to the wind, and there was darkness. Today, concerning your life, I shall be calmness in Jesus' name. Why was it angel that rolled the stone? This would be a topic for another day. Why? The angel rolled the stone. This would be a topic for another day. People of God, how amazing will it have been if the entire human race is conscious of God's presence and tapped from the power of God and of His Holy Son Jesus Christ, especially now that the world is experiencing things from COVID-19. May the world obtain mercy to access the only advice power of Jesus. His power is still available. The power of Jesus is still available. Jesus is alive. Unto those who are conscious of Him, to deliver and to save them. His power is available to calm the storm of life. Matthew chapter 8, verse 27. Matthew 8, 27. His power is available to forgive sins in your life. Mark 2:7. His power is available to heal the sickness threatening your life. Mark 2:12. Mark 2:12. Jesus has the power to deal with every evil power causing sickness around the world today. If you can only look unto Him, and today He will do your own in Jesus' mighty name. His power is available to provide for the multitude. Mark 8:4. His power is available to cast out demons. Mark 9:22. His power is available to control the forces of nature. Mark 11:21. His power is available to come down from the cross. Mark 15:31. Mark 15:31. Jesus will come down from the cross where He was dead, but for the salvation of humanity, He has to be there to complete the task of saving the entire world. And lastly, His power is available. This unrealized power is available. Fearing death, Jesus has conquered death for your sake. John 11:37. John 11:37. And also John 20:25. John 11:37. John 20:25. Now let us look at some ways we can access this unrealized power of Jesus today. Number one, how can we access this unrealized power of Jesus? Number one, by His mercy or by His favor. Look at first the epistle read to us and verse 9. In His mercy and His grace, God can show us favor to access His power. You can gain favor, access His power from God. Romans 9:15 says, I will have mercy on whom I will have mercy on. And I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion on. Number two, by faith we can access this unrealized power of Jesus. By faith
sad question. In Luke chapter 18, verse 8b, Luke chapter 18, verse 8b, it read us, "Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he really find faith on the earth?" Luke chapter 18, verse 8b. And that becomes a concern. When Jesus Christ will come, will he find faith on earth? Of course, we need to bow the only last power of Jesus by faith, which is the assurance of being spoken for, the evidence of this sin. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 1.
People of God, we can exercise the faith that you have come to God in 1 John chapter 5 verse 4. Your victory over the world can be tapped through faith. 1 John chapter 5 verse 4. Number 3, how can we access the unrealized power of Jesus Christ? By obedience. Apostle Paul in his epistle to the Romans, through that is, in Romans chapter 16, verses 25 and 27. "Now to him that is of power to stabilize you according to my gospel, and to the preaching of Jesus according to the revelation of the mystery which was kept secret since the world began." Verse 26. "But now is made manifest, and by the scriptures of the prophet, according to the commandments of the everlasting God, made known to all nations for the obedience of faith." Romans chapter 16, verses 25 and 27. And verse 27 says, "To God only wise be glory through Jesus." To God only wise be glory through Jesus. We know that by the grace and the mercy of the Lord, we will see come back to the church and say to God the glory, because He's the only one that is wise. This year, the time of our year of glorious celebration, we will celebrate, even this year, after COVID-19, in the name of Jesus. The way God is going to do it, I don't know, but I believe God. I have assurance that God will do it for us. This church shall be full again, in the name of Jesus. We shall enjoy fellowship again with the Almighty God, with one another again. Brethren, and do the bidding of God. You are here, you have never given your life to Jesus. Today is your day. Please give your life to Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Almighty God, we have heard your word, O Lord. Strengthen our faith in God, that we may depart from this unrealized power of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, pray. Thank you.
proceed from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Lord, your mercy.
There are prayers.
Let us pray. Let us pray for the church and the world. And let us thank God for his goodness. Lord, we are saying, Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we promise you your Son Jesus Christ to hear us from the break of faith, strengthen the hearing, our private, and we share with our ambition, for love to achieve our vision. And all your church in the service of Christ, that those who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and regain your glory in the world. Lord, your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Bless the guide our rulers, especially Buhari, our president, Yemi, his wife, Shehi, our governor. Give wisdom to all in authority and direct us and every nation in the way of justice and of peace, that people may honor one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy, give grace to our families and friends and to all our neighbors, that we may serve Christ upon our mother and love as he loves us. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body and mind and spirit, especially those who are victims of COVID-19. Give them courage and hope in their troubles and bring them the joy of your salvation. God, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ. According to your promise, grant us with them to share in your eternal kingdom. God, in your mercy, let us bring our personal petition to the Lord. Let's tell him whatever is going on. Lord, in your mercy, rejoicing in the fellowship of all your saints, commend ourselves and all Christian people to your unfailing love, merciful Father.
Save this prayer for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please let us rise. Christ is our peace, and he has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and we share his peace. Peace of the Lord be always with you. Please let us bow and our sign of peace.
Thank you.
holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord of power and might, heaven and earth above for glory, Sana in the eyes. Sana in the eyes.
Lord,
bless you. Bless you. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours ever and ever. Amen.
This bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, no one body, because we share one bread.
Lamb of God, will take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, will take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, will take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace. We do not presume to come to your table. Merciful Lord, trust in our righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. You are not worthy so much as carry out from our table. We try to see you. This nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, Jesus Christ, so to eat the flesh of your Son, Jesus Christ, and to bring this blood that we evermore dwell in you. And he in us. Amen.
Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him your heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ is growing like a child.
Jesus came and stood among his disciples and said to them, "Peace be unto you." Hallelujah. The Lord be with you. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us, and lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. God of all, give me thanks and praise that when we are still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Thine and living, declare your love. Give us grace and open the gates of glory. May we who share Christ live his risen life, who will drink his cup, bring light to others. Be who the Spirit's light, give light to the world. Keep us found in the hope that you have set before us. So we, your children, shall be free, and the world that live to praise your name through Christ.
You may respond to the answer.
I
Lord bless and keep you. Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Lord give God his countenance upon you and give you peace. Peace in your heart, peace in your home, both now and forever.
Yeah. Scripture.